How to hide crypto assets for privacy purposes. This is a subject that quite a few people seem to have some interest in. To give you some ideas, we're going to go over a few things in this video. You're going to want to use wallets and non-KYC exchanges, even possibly OTC, things that are not linked to your identity. Right. And when you go on those exchanges, you don't want to link your bank account that's opened under your name or a business that's opened under your name or, you know, anything like that. You're also going to want to use VPN. And if you want to get really extreme, you could potentially buy, you know, maybe an inexpensive laptop or a tablet and use that with VPN exclusively for what you're doing. In addition to that, if you can, get a VPN provider by using a credit card through a service like privacy.com, I believe, offers credit cards where you just put some money in and you can use a card that the card itself isn't directly linked to your name or your bank account. Although, you know, obviously if the authorities were to, you know, go through legal channels and request information from a service like that, they could probably still get records, right? So essentially though, you want to use as many things as you can, all things really that are in the chain of obtaining and self-custodying crypto that is not linked directly to you. And that means that you can't use any existing wallets. Like if you have a wallet that you have transferred funds to from a KYC exchange, such as Coinbase, then you're not going to use that wallet for this purpose, right? You're going to use basically a dark wallet, you know, a wallet that has never sent or received to any address that can be linked to you. So that also means no transferring crypto from a wallet that's not already a dark wallet to your new dark wallet. And by dark wallet, I'm talking about just making sure that there's nothing to tie it to any specific person. And that involves using things like VPN, not doing any transactions with a KYC exchange. The problem with stuff like this, though, is, in my view, you know, I'm not a financial advisor, I'm not a lawyer, I'm not a tax professional, so this is just me talking and just giving you my opinion. My opinion there is that the only real purpose of going to that links for privacy's sake is really because probably you don't have any intentions of declaring any profits, which means tax evasion, which here in the United States of America, where I live, that's a felony. A felony is a serious crime. So I personally am not super interested in going to great lengths to protect my privacy when it comes to crypto in these ways. Because at the end of the day, if I get really, really lucky and I turn $15,000 or $20,000 into, you know, $3.8 million. No, of course I don't want to cough up $1 million or more in taxes. I want to keep my money. Who doesn't? But you know what else I like? Not being found out for doing something that's a crime and then paying the price for it. Also, you know, if I got really extraordinarily lucky, let's say I had $50 million of profit, the way I see it, I could either have all that stuff hidden and never report it, never pay taxes on it, and then keep it, right? But I would always be worried about being found out. And what goes hand in hand in that is I wouldn't really be able to fully appreciate and enjoy those tens of millions of dollars. Because as it stands right now, I have around $14,000 worth of crypto, and I make around $70,000 a year. And I don't have a bunch of other, you know, large investments. So I don't really have a ton of money, right? If I suddenly bought a house now around Southern California in the United States of America, it's very easy to spend $600,000 or more on a single family detached house. So if all of a sudden me, with my income history and the amount of wealth that, you know, the government would know about, if I suddenly, you know, were living in a $1.1 million house or even a $700,000 house, that alone could raise some red flags, right? And then they could come looking as to what's going on, find out, oh, you've got wealth that you never declared. Sorry to tell you, pal, but there's a price to pay for that now, right? So if I wouldn't be able to do things like go buy a nice boat, not that I'm a big boat person, not the point though. If I can't, you know, if I have $50 million and I'm thinking I don't want to pay $15, $20, $25, $30 million in taxes, I get that, right? Who doesn't? Like, who wants to give up that much money to tax? But it's going to be difficult really spending it if you're not very careful. So you could do these things. I just don't really see the big advantage. unless your entire point is that you want to intentionally commit crimes where taxes are concerned. And well, I'm not here to recommend that.